The next item of business is Stage 3 proceedings on the House and Cladding Remediation Scotland Bill. In dealing with the amendments, members should have the Bill as amended at Stage 2, that is Scottish Parliament Bill 36A, the marshalled list and the groupings of amendments. Members should also note the updated procedural notes for Group 3 circulated with the timed groupings. The division bell will sound and proceedings will be suspended for around 5 minutes for the first division of the Stage 3. The period of voting for the first division will be 45 seconds, and thereafter I will allow a voting period of 1 minute for the first division after a debate. Members who wish to speak in the debate on any group of amendments should press their request to speak buttons or enter RTS in the chat as soon as possible after I call the group. Members should now refer to the marshalled list of amendments. And we move to Group 1, information to be provided in registers and reports. I call Amendment 9 in the name of Mark Griffin, grouped with Amendments 14, 43 and 44. Mark Griffin to move Amendment 9 and speak to all amendments in the group.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I move Amendment 9 in my name. Despite Scottish Government's reports, we still don't understand the true extent to which combustible materials have been used in buildings in Scotland. The single building assessment is an opportunity to help address that. The Scottish Government's first high-rise inventory, published in 2020, did not request or detail the Euroclass ratings of material used, making it impossible to know whether they are combustible. Now, despite agreeing to consider recommendations to address this, no changes were made to the 2021 survey. Further survey work following the last iteration of the high-rise inventory will form part of the Register of Safe Buildings. A key part of determining whether a building is safe is knowing, it must be knowing what materials has been used and the makeup of that external wall system. The Scottish Government, since the launch of the single building assessment, has always maintained the position that they're engaging with residents in those buildings affected by combustible materials. Then Cabinet Secretary Shona Robson stated in 2022, if cladding is assessed to be high risk, homeowners will be invited to discuss the assessment and to agree to actions that will be required to make their buildings safe. The Scottish Government have since maintained they would be open, transparent and engage with those residents affected. Presiding Officer, how can that be the case if they're not willing to detail to residents, to owners, what the building is constructed with? The Government should also clarify what detail will be made available and what the reasoning is for not outlining what materials have been used in the construction of the external wall. Now, the argument set out by the Minister in Stage 2 was that releasing information may be, and I quote, to the detriment of homeowners if insurers or mortgage providers were to use that information to refuse on a blanket basis to insure or lend to that building. But surely the Government must be working with those institutions, engaging with that sector ahead of this bill, and working to define what the SBA process will be. That engagement should have mitigated any risk. And if it doesn't, then it begs the question of whether the Scottish Government has listened adequately to the concerns raised. And so we have real concerns then whether the SBA process and the bill will have the desired effect if residents simply aren't told what their building is made with. On Amendments 14 and 44, house builders in Scotland believe that the creation of a cladding assurance register in principle is appropriate as a record of what properties have been remediated. However, there is a lack of clarity as to what information is to be provided in the register and who specifically should be responsible for the remediation. Is it the developer or is it a homeowner who's potentially not maintained a building? Now, with so much of this process hanging on the key concept of the single building assessment, it's essential that all parties that will be impacted by it have full clarity at the outset of what a Scottish single building assessment is, its specification, what it looks like and what standards it's assessing. None of that detail for a key concept, a key policy proposal is provided in the bill. We should be giving people, we should be giving residents, developers, much more clarity about the details that should be contained within an SBA and an idea of how that register would be used in practice. Now, this amendment would clarify who has responsibility for carrying out actions set out within the single building assessment. Not all risks identified will be due to the construction of the building, and given the nature of the fact that some of these buildings are decades old, the risk may have emerged through a lack of maintenance or adaption. The Minister's opinion was that the process in the bill would give them that information. The Minister offered to pick that up and discuss the SBA process when that is completed, and reiterated that the SBA process currently includes developers and stakeholders. The Presiding Officer, that assurance is welcome. We welcome that assurance, but it doesn't go far enough. For the key concept in this bill to be the single building assessment, we feel that far more information should be included on the face of this bill, and seek to do that through this amendment. Thank you.
Thank you, and I call the Minister.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. On Amendment 9 and 43, these amendments seek to add technical detail to the face of the bill, and Mark Griffin and I have had a number of discussions both in committee and out with committee on this point, and obviously many others. However, the purpose of the bill is to facilitate delivery of the cladding remediation programme. It is not appropriate that the bill set out the technical detail of what the SBA report must contain. These standards will be set by the SBA specification, which Scottish ministers will issue, and we are in discussions obviously with developers at the moment, and obviously mentioned that at committee also. Nor is it appropriate for the cladding assurance register to make information about the type and Euroclass rating of the cladding and insulation on the building publicly available, particularly before the building has been remediated, which is what his amendment would require. It is important that the type of cladding and associated risk is seen within the wider context of the SBA and not in isolation. Adding this detail to the cladding assurance register and the meaning of the SBA in the bill would provide only a partial view. I therefore reject these amendments and urge members to do the same. On these amendments 14 and 44, determining responsibility for assessment and remediation is not part of the SBA, nor is it appropriate for the relevant technical expert undertaking his assessment. The purpose of the SBA is to comprehensively assess the risk to human life that is directly or indirectly created or exacerbated by a building's external wall cladding system. And I think that's an important point to reiterate. The Scottish Safer Buildings Developer Remediation Contract will set out what we expect of responsible developers, and of course in the case of buildings for which is responsibility, what the government will do. I do not accept this would enhance what's in the bill, nor distract from the purpose of the SBA. The issue that Mr Griffin is concerned with in his amendment has already been dealt with as part of the opening contract discussions, which are continuing with the developers at the moment. I therefore reject his amendment and ask members to do the same.
Thank you. Mark Griffin, to wind up and to press or withdraw Amendment 9.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I think when it comes to the very basics that people who live in these buildings are asking for is to know what their building is made of. I think there is an obligation on government through the course of the assessment to tell residents that very, very basic information, to be transparent and open with them when it comes to what their home is made of. When it comes to the other amendments in this group, like I said, the committee report agreed that the single building assessment was the key concept within this legislation. We don't feel that this should be left to regulation, that there should be far more clarity, there should be far more certainty given to the developers who are potentially picking up the bill, or the residents who are currently in those buildings, to leave that to further scrutiny, not at the level of full legislative scrutiny. And so I press Amendment 9 in my name.
Thank you. The question is that Amendment 9 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are not agreed. There will be a division, and as this is the first division off the stage, I suspend for around 5 minutes to allow members to access the digital voting system.